Hey guys, so today I created this look with the new Makeup Geek Champagne and Rosé palette. I also tried out their new retractable eyeliners today. So if you want to see how I got this look and my thoughts on these products, go ahead and keep on watching. I'm going to start by priming my eye with the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot, and I'm using a Sigma P87 brush to apply it. Now I'm going to go into the Makeup Geek Champagne and Rosé palette. I'm going to pick up the shade Berries on a Sigma E25, and I'm going to keep this shade nice and low in my crease. This is going to look really, really sloppy and like not blended at first. Now I'm going to pick up Rosé on the same brush, and I'm going to use this to help blend out berries. So I'm going a little bit higher towards my brow. Alright, see how that looks a lot more blended now, but you can totally see a harsh line right here. So whenever I talk about not wanting any harsh lines, this is exactly what I'm talking about. You can clearly see where my skin is and where the eyeshadow is, and you want this to look blended. So I'm going to take a Sweet Cream still on the same brush, and I'm going to put this right in that little area. And this shade is so close to my skin tone that it's perfect for this kind of step. And I'm not bringing this shade any lower because if I did, it would make these purple shades look kind of ashy. I'm just using it right up here to blend. See how that harshness has like totally gone away? All right, so that looks nice and blended now. I'm gonna take Merlot on a Sigma E45, and I'm gonna use this to deepen up my outer corner. And I'm keeping it really, really low on my lid. I'm gonna take a little bit more rosé on my E25 and put that kind of in the center of my lid, just to make this darker shade blend into my lid a little bit nicer. Now I'm gonna take the shade Champagne on a Sigma E58. I did get my brush a little bit wet, and this shade is gonna go on the inner part of my lid. You could do like a half cut crease if you wanted to, but I'm just gonna keep it a little bit softer today. And I'm gonna blend around the edges of that with my E25. All right, now I'm gonna do some eyeliner. So Makeup Geek came out with some new retractable eyeliners. They look like this, and I'm just gonna use the shade Black. I like how they're just called like what they are. It's not some fancy shade name. And I'm gonna put that along my lash line. Now I'm gonna take a little bit of Merlot on a Sigma E21, and I'm gonna use that to smudge out the eyeliner. All right, that looks good. I'm gonna go do my face makeup, and then we'll come back and finish up the eyes. I'm gonna take the new Makeup Geek eyeliner in the shade Purple, and I'm gonna line all across my bottom lash line. Just like in between my lashes. Now I'm gonna take Berries on my E21, and I'm gonna use that to smudge out the purple. Now I'm gonna pick up Rosé on the same brush and use that a little bit lower to kind of help blend it out. Now I'm gonna take the black eyeliner again, and I'm gonna put that in my waterline. I find that this applies really, really easily to the lash line and the waterline, so that's amazing. Now I'm gonna go pop on some mascara and lashes. All right, so for lashes, I use Lily Lashes Mykonos, and here's the final look. I think this is so, so pretty. I love the purpley tones of like the champagne kind of rosy color. I think out of the two new Makeup Geek palettes, I definitely prefer the Peach Bellini one. I just see myself using these type of shades a little bit more often than the palette I use today. But the shadows are freaking amazing as always. Makeup Geek is incredible. So if these are colors that you would see yourself using, I would highly recommend this. The new eyeliners were also really, really nice as well. Like I said, they applied really nicely on the lash line and in the waterline. Makeup Geek just kills it as always. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.